Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. The National Energy Regulator of South Africa has given Engineering News some insight into the process it is likely to adopt to give concurrence to two ministerial determinations recently drafted by Minister Gwede Mantashe. Terence Screamer joins me to discuss this development. Hi, Terence.
Hi, Chanel.
Why is Nersa's concurrence needed?
Well, Nersa needs to concur with these Section 34 ministerial determinations which allow for the procurement of power by independent power producers, whichever technology is being procured, whether it's renewable energy, which we've had quite a number of those procured in the past, coal. In terms of the current integrated resource plan, there's also battery storage. There's also going to be hydro at some point. So this is a legal requirement. And in the past, this used to just be a signature process. So the minister would draft the determination and the chairperson of Nersa would sign it, and then we would go about procurement. But since the nuclear ruling judgment, the courts have ruled that Nersa has to go through its full regulatory process, which requires public participation in the form of written and oral commentary. And this is what we now have to go through now with these latest determinations which have been delivered to Nersa by Minister Gwede Mantashe.
What process is the regulator likely to follow?
Well, it was unclear initially because we had this emergency to close 3,000 megawatts gap that is prevailing in South Africa, and we know as a result of that gap we've already experienced load shedding intensively since December. So there was a view that maybe the process could be streamlined or shortened in some way, but I think it's been confirmed now that we're going to go through the normal process for both the ministerial determination for the emergency procurement of up to 3,000 megawatts, as well as the technology-specific normal utility-scale procurement. We're going to also go through this full process, which involves the publication of a consultation paper, which Nersa needs to release on its website. It will do that together with the determinations. And then there'll be a period of public comment where there'll be a deadline submitted or issued for the submission of written comments. And then typically that will be followed by public hearings, which Nersa seems to have confirmed now there will be public hearings. What form those public hearings will take is still not clear, whether it's going to be one big public hearing nationally or whether it's going to be a series of provincial hearings as we become accustomed to when Eskom, for instance, has a tariff application. That's the sort of norm. I think we'll have to wait and see, and I think we'll know fairly soon as to what that will entail.
What does this mean for South Africa in terms of closing the immediate power gap?
Well, I think it means that there's going to be a delay to any procurement, both the emergency procurement as well as the normal utility-scale procurement, whether it's bid window 5 or the renewable energy program or, say, a coal procurement program or anything else that might arise. So the Department of Energy has indicated there could be up to 6-month delay. Nersa is saying they're going to try and do it within the next 3 months. So that means that there won't be any procurement processes initiated. I think that's going to be a disappointment to the market, who I think we were all expecting with the publication of the RP in October last year, that by the beginning of this year, 2020, that we'll start seeing procurement happening. We know that we're in an urgent situation because we're already having load shedding. It intensified since December, and we've already seen a lot of bouts of load shedding this year. So we need to get moving. But I think that because of the nuclear ruling, and this is the first time there's going to be concurrence post the nuclear ruling, the nurse is going to want to sort of dot all the I's, cross all the T's in this process to make sure it's legally competent, and therefore it's going to exercise or err on the side of caution, which is going to delay procurement, and potentially for South Africa it's going to mean a longer period of load shedding. Because none of these projects can come in overnight. Even the emergency procurement has sort of given a window till the end of 2021 to be delivered. So that's the end of next year. And then the utility scale projects, if we start procuring them this year, I think the typical time frame is 18 to 24 months. So there's going to be no immediate new capacity additions, which means that we're going to have to be living within our power means as South African. And at the moment, I suppose we are able to do that because of the very slow growth, which is having other social, negative social and economic consequences. But at some point when we start growing again, we're going to start hitting the limits of what Eskom can supply, so we need to get moving. So the only other avenue here is to get the self-generation market really moving in the interim. And that is also, there's still some uncertainty around that. Even though Nersa is saying the rules are clear, Schedule 2 of the Energy Regulation Act is clear, that anything above 1 megawatt needs licensing, there still seems to be uncertainty for the larger scale projects. And we really need to hit that nail on the head so that we can get the mines and the factories and the farms that want to self-generate, and the houses as well, which I think many are already looking at that, but to start doing that self-generation, because on the larger front, the utility scale front, I think there's going to be delay.
Thank you. That's the Second Take show for this week. Thank you for watching, and join us again next time for more news analysis. Also, don't forget to listen to the audio version of our Engineering News daily email newsletter.